Hey ghouls and gals, welcome back to my channel. My name is Taylor and today's video is going to be my favorite characters book tag. Since it is close to Valentine's Day, at the time that you're seeing this, I thought it'd be really fun to do this tag because February, and Valentine's Day in particular, is really all about love, and I thought it would be really fun to do a characters that I love book tag. Now, full disclosure, I am not doing all of the questions in the original tag. I will leave the original tag down in the description box. I just thought the first 7 questions were about characters that you liked, right? And then prompts 8 through 10 were about characters that you didn't like, so I just wanted to focus on the characters that I really liked. So I'm not gonna be doing this whole tag. I'm skipping questions 8, 9, and 10, but if you wanna do this whole tag, it is linked down below. I originally saw this tag on Little Wolf's channel, so I'll leave her original video down below. She's like the queen of the tags. She finds all the fun tags to do. So let's just get started. Prompt number 1 is a character that you love fiercely. And for this one, I'm going with one of my very first bookish loves, and that is going to be Lyra Blackwa from the His Dark Materials trilogy. When I first read this series, I was about Lyra's age when I first began reading the series, maybe a little bit older. I think I was in 6th or 7th grade. And I absolutely took to her as a character. She was essentially my foil in a lot of ways. I was definitely a kid that was like a bookworm. I was a rule follower. I was a good student. I kept my nose in a book and I kept my nose out of trouble at the same time. And Lyra is very definitely none of those things. Now, she is a very smart young girl, but she just really has this feisty personality, mind of her own. If an adult is going to tell her to do something, she better get the reasoning why, or she's not going to do it. Lyra is just so brave and so fearless and just so wonderfully spunky that I just wanted to be her as a kid. The series as a whole really shines because of the characters, and Lyra is just the perfect main character for this story that is about growing up and the differences between being a child and having that wonder and childhood innocence, and then just kind of growing up and getting different perspectives and different worldviews, and I just wanted to be her so bad. I was in like 7th grade when the original movie came out of The Golden Compass, and that is definitely not my favorite adaptation, although I thought the casting was spot on for all of the characters, but I'm really enjoying the new TV show adaptation, so if you haven't checked that out, I'd highly recommend it. I think it's a wonderfully done blend of staying really, really true to the book and then changing around some things that are so subtle just in terms of timelines and interweaving stories that make it more cohesive for TV as opposed to the books. So that's a wonderful adaptation. Daphne Keene is the actress that plays her on that show, and I think she captures the spirit of Lyra so perfectly. Lyra is just such a wonderful children's character that I just absolutely have a soft spot for. I know she's not to everyone's taste. I know a lot of people definitely think she's more of an unlikable character, but she's very much a realistic child, and a realistic child who wants to do what is best for the greater good, and a child has different opinions of that than most adults would, so I think that's really wonderful and magical, and I love her so fiercely. Prompt number 2 is a character that is heavily flawed, but you cannot help but love, and I'm gonna have to go with my girl Rin from the Poppy War series. It is, I know, quite honestly embarrassing to the extent that I love Rin, and I support her decisions, and I don't think she's that unlikable of a character. I know a lot of people in reviews will mention that the characters are very unlikable, and to an extent, definitely. She's very, very morally gray, but I absolutely love Rin. She has her flaws, and she's very impulsive. There is a little bit of a theme of this list of characters that I really enjoy, but she is very headstrong. She is in a society where the whole world is pitted against her. The situations in which she's born and the biases in her society do not set her up for success. She acknowledges it's a failed system, she acknowledges it's a flawed system, and she has no qualms with clawing her way to the top. A lot of my favorite Rin moments really have to do with, I don't know if anyone's seen the meme going around about the good for her cinematic universe when it comes to horror movies, and just some female protagonists in horror movies that we tend to root for, and you know, those good for her moments, but a lot of moments are like that. Does she make the best decisions all the time? No. know, does she solve conflict in a good way? Absolutely not. But you understand her intentions and you understand her struggle in a world that is so deeply unfair to people who look like her. Her whole character is pretty much doing whatever comes to mind and taking a very personal justice out on the world in a very vigilante sort of way. Do we love to see it in books? Yes. Should we do it in real life? No, but it's really, really fun sometimes living it out through characters like Rin. The third prompt is a character that made you laugh out loud, and for that one I'm going to go with one of my more recent books that I picked up, and that's going to be Sparrow from To Sleep in a Sea of Stars by Christopher Paolini. I listened to the audiobook on this book, and that's definitely the way to go. The narrator does an amazing job. It's a single narration audiobook, and the narrator has such specific voices for each characters, and it's a large cast of characters. But not only is Sparrow herself a character that I did like when I was reading it physically, and then I did switch to audio later, because I think that is the way that you should really absorb this story, but the voice was just paired so perfectly with Sparrow. Sleep in a Sea of Stars is a sci-fi story about first contact with aliens, and you're following a very ragtag group of unlikely heroes aboard a spacecraft, and Sparrow is the ship's kind of captain of security. She's ex-military, she doesn't play by the rules. She very much gives me Cara Dune vibes, if Cara Dune like cracked more jokes, those kind of vibes. But the voice the narrator did for her was so perfect, and she just had so many like fun one-liners in the book. I absolutely loved it. And she's one of those characters that pretends like they don't have any feelings, and then when you finally wrestle some genuine emotion and feeling out of her, just, you know, the bashful way they kind of admit it and play it off like it's not a big deal, even though it is. She is definitely a character that looks like a badass but is actually a cinnamon roll inside, and that was just really fun to read from. She's not even one of the main characters, I would argue, in this book. She's very much like a heavily reoccurring secondary character, but just every scene that she's in, she brought so much to it, and I really enjoyed her as a character. The fourth prompt is a child character that you like, and I'm gonna go with Kippa from the Monstrous graphic novel series. I absolutely adore Kippa. She is adorable. I didn't even think that she was going to be around. There are 5 volumes now of Monstrous out right now. I had kind of thought that she wasn't going to be as big of a part as she was. And then as you're going through the story of volume 1, you're slowly realizing that she is going to stay for a lot of reasons in the first volume, not getting into spoilers, but there is a lot of character turnover, so it was a really fun surprise to realize that she was going to be one of the main characters of the series. And she is just, first of all, her character design is so adorable. It's very complex world building, so I'm not gonna get too much into it, but you know, she's got her little fox ears and a fox tail, and she is just so sweet. The main character of Monstrous, Micah, she is very much a person who needs to learn how to love, learn how to have friends. She's very gruff and prickly, and she doesn't make friends easily, and Pippa is like this adorable little foil who always sees the best in people, and she is always pushing people to make not just maybe what is convenient and the right choice for them, but the right choice for the greater good. She's so sweet and she's so funny, and in volumes 4 and 5, we're kind of seeing her start to come into her own as this character grows up a little bit more, which is going to be so exciting to watch. She's just very sweet and very wholesome and just a cute, precious child that is thrust into the middle of the war, and she is going from like place to place with this group of essentially assassins, morally gray assassins, and they're very ruthless and cutthroat, and they all pretend like they don't like each other, and Kippa is just the cute little glue that holds the group together. She is just a lot of fun to read from, and she does have some of the best one-liners and jokes in this series as well. Prompt number 5 is an animal character that you really like, and I'm gonna split this up into 2 different parts because technically neither of them are animals. I guess one is more than the other, but the first one is Pantalaimon from the His Dark Materials series. He is Lyra's demon, so technically he is half of her soul, so these animals are not animals. It's just the personification of the person's personality in animal form, which is the best part of His Dark Materials. Well, one of them. I absolutely love this series, but as a kid, one of the main pulls to this series is that everyone has part of your soul outside of your body that is connected to you, that is your demon counterpart. culture part, and that animal, when you're a kid, it can change shapes as much as it wants. Once you become an adult, it settles into its main form, and that is a representation of who you are as a person. I loved him. I loved the idea of him, first of all, as an entity, which was really, really cool. But I also really loved how he was Lyra's foil in a lot of ways. He was the one who, when she's like, all right, let's jump, he's like, wait a minute, let's think about this situation a little bit more. And then the other character that I absolutely love is, I am unsure of how to pronounce this, so I've got the book right here, but it's Nymathun, and it is Tane's dragon in the Priory of the Orange Tree. I absolutely loved how not just Western dragon mythology was used in this book, but Eastern dragon mythology as well, and the differences between the lores of like our world, but put into a different fantasy world was really, really cool. And the dragon riders in Priory of the Orange Tree is, it definitely gives me like Aragorn with one of my first young adult fantasy books that I ever read. I absolutely love that concept. So whenever it's in a book, I love it. So I'm really a sucker for that dynamic relationship in a book, and I just, yeah, I loved the dragons in this one, and this is definitely making me want to do a reread. And honestly, I could add a lot of different creatures that Priory of the Orange Tree had in here, because there were a lot of different mythological creatures in here that I thought were super cool. So the next prompt is a strong woman character that you like, and for that one we're sticking with Samantha Shannon, but I'm gonna go with Paige Mahoney from The Bone Season. Now, I'm not very far into this series at all, but I can already tell that Paige is just going to be one of those protagonists that I absolutely fall in love with, and I'm going to be really excited to watch her grow throughout what is going to be a 7-book series. I'm so excited. I've already got the 4th book pre-ordered, even though I'm not to the 3rd yet, but I love her character. I really enjoyed from chapter 1. You really get a sense of what Paige is all about, what her place is in the world, and maybe how that doesn't really add up with what she believes her place in the world is. It's very much, if you haven't read The Bone Season, sort of in some ways, I would say almost maybe a chosen one, but definitely a reluctant sort of chosen one. And obviously I'm not up to date with the series because I haven't read all of the books yet. So I don't know if it's technically a chosen one trope or not, but I really enjoy how Paige at the beginning, even at the end of book one, from the beginning to the end of book one, you can see how much that she is already growing as a character and how much she is taking control of herself and her situation and really growing confidence and growing into the person and the abilities that she has and just really that self-love and self-confidence journey. I just really love her. I think she's a sweetheart. There was one part in The Bone Season where she was talking about how because she has this really unique ability, she's never truly felt like if people like her for just her abilities or if they like her for her, and I just wanted to reach through the book pages and give her a hug because she is so sweet like that, and she is also just such a generous character that several times throughout the books, she is put in situations where she would rather put herself in peril to save someone or just to even make sure that they're not in harm's way, and she's just so selfless but so realistic about being selfless. She definitely struggles with her role in society and the role that she has, and honestly, the first book is kind of a lot like Spider-Man with the whole with great power comes great responsibility bit, and I love seeing that progression to a very reluctant person who just wants to remain on the outside of conflict to coming closer and closer into the very middle of the conflict, and I love that journey for her. And then the last prompt that I'm gonna do, but just remember there are more prompts if you want to do this whole tag down below, but the last prompt for me is a brave character that you admire, and for that one I'm going with Hero from The First Sister by Lyndon A. Lewis. Hero is a character where I don't want to give too much away about the plot, but you pretty much find out from the 2nd chapter that Hero, spelled H-I-R was a hero for their side of this conflict that is going on until all of a sudden they mysteriously disappear and they start working for the enemy. Now this is very puzzling to a lot of people that Hero was close with, especially Hero's partner, and I mean partner in like they were a squadron unit, but there definitely is some like romantic tension there, but Everyone is confused why Hiro, who is this really respected person on their side of this conflict, would suddenly join the other side and essentially turn traitor. So a large part of the first sister is trying to figure out, number one, where Hiro has gone exactly, and also why did Hiro switch sides, and why did this really respected person turn traitor to a cause that was near and dear to their heart? And I can't give too much away because a lot of these are plot points that are revealed throughout the book, and probably more will be revealed throughout the series, but Hiro is so selfless, and I just really respect a character who is very much a character that just feels a calling to the greater good. And maybe even though it's not the most comfortable position for them to be in, they're going to choose what is right as opposed to what would benefit them or what would make their lives easier, because the decisions that Hiro makes, they believe that the decisions are for the best and for the greater good and will ultimately help the most amount of people. But it's making Hiro look like this horrible traitor and despicable turncoat. And I think it's a rare person that can get rid of their whole entire life and reputation and standing and make everyone that you loved believe that you're less of a person to actually fight for the greater good. And some of the things they do are very much behind the scenes. They are not in it for the glory. And so a lot of the good that they do, their loved ones will never know about. So I really admire Hiro as a character. I think that is so incredibly brave and selfless, and I don't think a lot of people, when put in that situation, would be able to make all of those decisions and a lot of hard decisions as flawlessly as Hiro was able to do throughout this book, and hopefully in the sequel coming out soon. So there you have it. Those were just some of my favorite characters, characters that I love, because I generally love February, love Valentine's Day. I think it's honestly a really fun holiday, but I thought it would be fun to do a tag about characters that I love in the month of love right around Valentine's Day. So yeah. If you also want to do this tag, definitely I will leave all the information down below. Like I said, there are three more prompts that I didn't do, just talking about your least favorite characters, but I really wanted to focus, since tis the season, I really wanted to focus on characters that I absolutely loved and some of my current favorite characters at the moment. But that is going to be it for this video, so definitely give it a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, let me know who your favorite character at the moment is, subscribe for more content from me, stay safe, stay spooky, and I'll see y'all on the other side. Bye!